November 1st, 2022. I have my interview today to become a US citizen. Today is a very, very, very special day for me. I get to become a US citizen today. Hopefully, by the grace of God, I have my interview today at 12 p.m. So I'm all dressed up for it. I have been studying for this. I am prepped for this, so I am good to go.
Yes, I passed my interview. Oh my God. Okay. I'm just going to calm down. Okay. Yes, everything went fine. I passed.
Good morning and welcome to my channel. My name is Joy, and as you can see, I'm all smiles and I'm happy today. I'm going to swear my oath ceremony today and oath of allegiance to the United States of America. Today is November 29th, 2022. I cannot believe today is finally here. And I'm ready. Yep, let me move back so you can. I'm ready. I'm leaving a little early so I can pick up my auntie who lives like 45 minutes away from me. And plus, it is snowing. And every time it snows here in the Twin Cities, Minnesota, driving is a nightmare. I will see you guys soon.
Yes, I'm in my car. I'm ready to go. I'm hearing like 4 to 5 inches of snow today, and it is 27 degrees. It is cold, so I will talk to you guys soon. I finally made it to her house. It is still snowing. She's looking at me from the window. Yeah. Oh, the roads are so slippery. It is so bad out there. But thank God I'm here. I'm waiting for her in the car. That's her house right here.
Hello, welcome back again. I am back and oh my God, it is official. I am officially a US citizen. I cannot believe it. This is still like a dream to me. It was wonderful. It was awesome. That's what I can tell you guys. The experience is something I will never forget in my life. This journey hasn't been easy, hasn't been smooth, but I made it to this point in my life. And oh my God, I'm still trying to process this day. It is too much to process. It was a lot. It was awesome. It was wonderful. Even with the snow, the weather, it's still snowing out there. There was a lot of crashes on my way home, but thank God I made it home. It was 1,000 of us today. 99 countries represented today. And they called out the names of all the countries that was represented. It was awesome. It was so emotional for me and a whole lot of other people inside that auditorium today. I'm so grateful to God. I am so thankful to God, and I am so happy today. My auntie was the bomb. She was everything. She even got me a little gift, a very nice book. Look at this. Oh my God. Succulent White Woman, Dancing with Your Wonderful Self by Sack. I haven't read it yet. I just glanced through it. I'm loving it already. And it looks like it was, it's like handwritten. Even look at that. I am going to read it. Yes. And I am so happy today that this day is officially over. This journey is officially over. And I am now a US citizen. Today I'm going to talk about my timeline, how long it took me from the day I applied, and I also tell you a little bit about me and some encouragement to some people out there who are on the verge of giving up on their dreams, who are on the verge of throwing in the towel. So my timeline, I applied March 8th, 2022. My interview was scheduled September 26th, 2022. I had my interview November 1st, 2022, and my oath ceremony today, November 29th, 2022. It was so easy, you know. I mean, I was nervous. At first you will be, but don't be. Just be yourself, study the civic tests, which is like the 2008 100 civic tests. Study your N400 forms and you're just gonna be fine. Do not be afraid. Go in there with confidence and you're going to pass the interview. So it took 8 months from March to November for my own timeline. And depending on your case, it might take less, it might take even longer than my own, but mine took just 8 months, and I'm so happy that it finally came to an end. A little bit about me. My life hasn't been that smooth. I lost my parents when I was small. I grew up with my grandmother, and as a child, I had polio. And because of that, I limp. I have a limp on my right leg. But growing up as a child, I was bullied because of the limp on my leg. I was mocked, I was laughed at. I was called all sorts of names by some kids in school. I lost my confidence, my self-esteem. I became an introvert because of that. Long story short, I found myself in America, all alone, no family members, no blood related family members, no relations, no brother, no sister, no father, no anybody. It wasn't easy. It hasn't been easy. I have been told that I will never survive or make it on my own, but I'm still here today celebrating my victory, celebrating my success, celebrating my achievement of becoming a US citizen. And till this day, I still have no family in this country. But that's about to change now by the grace of God. And for those of you out there who are on the verge of giving up hope, who are on the verge of giving up on their dreams, on their goals, I know that sometimes life throws some punches at you and you feel like, can I survive this? It's never going to be easy. The road to success is not easy. There's always going to be a bump along the way. There's always going to be some roadblocks along the way. At some point during this journey, I thought about quitting. I thought about giving up. I thought about, you know what, I'm gonna go back to Nigeria. But something in me said, no, Joy, you're not a quitter. You are stronger than you think you are. And so today, I'm telling you that you are stronger than you think you are. And so today, I will tell you reasons why you should never ever think of giving up in your dreams. Number one, dreams take time. When you're on a journey of achieving your dreams and the goals that you set for yourself, one thing you should know is that it's gonna be a long process. It's not something that can happen overnight. But you have to trust the process. My journey didn't start today. It didn't start yesterday. No, it took time. I came to this country 9 years ago, and I'm just becoming a US citizen. My journey of self-discovery, of achieving my dreams, of achieving my goals didn't start today. It didn't even start when I came to US. It started years ago while I was still in Nigeria. So you are on a journey of achieving your dreams, of becoming that person that you want to be in life. You have to be patient and just follow the process. Believe in yourself. No matter how long it takes, as long as you did not give up, you did not quit on yourself, you will surely get to your final destination. So hang in there. Don't be in a hurry. If it didn't happen today, if it didn't happen tomorrow, that doesn't mean that it will never happen. It will surely come to pass. But you just have to stay put. You just have to believe in yourself and keep moving forward and never give up. Never quit. Number two, don't be afraid to fail. Along the way to achieving your dreams, you're going to fail. Not once, not twice, three times, even four times, you're going to fail. But do you give up when you fail? You learn from your failure and you keep going. And people are going to say things to you when you fail. They are going to laugh at you. They are going to mock you. But you know what? You keep moving. Before I came to the US, I didn't know how to drive. At my age, I wasn't driving. I learned how to drive in US. When I came to US, Minnesota to be precise, because getting buses around this city is kind of difficult in some areas, so I had to learn how to drive. I failed my driving test the first time, the second time, the third time. The third time, I was told, someone told me that there are some people in this world that are not meant to drive, that I was one of those people that are not meant to drive in this world. And I looked at the person and I told the person that I am going to get my driver's license and it's going to be a surprise. I went for the fourth trial and it was a surprise. Long story short, I got my driver's license on the fourth trial. So why am I telling you this? People are going to mock you. They are going to laugh at you. They are going to say a lot of things that will discourage you. But don't let yourself be discouraged by what people say. What matters is what you say to yourself. I told myself that day, I went inside the bathroom. I looked myself in the mirror and I told myself, Joy, you're going to get your driver's license. I am the kind of person that when I start something, I don't give up. I don't quit. No matter how hard it is, no matter how difficult it is. And I went the fourth time and I got my driver's license. So no matter how many times you fail, because you're going to fail, it's not a matter of if you're going to fail, no, it's how many times you're going to fail along the way, because you will fail along the way. But how you respond to the failure is entirely up to you. If you fail and you stay down, then you will never achieve anything in this life. If you're trying to give up because people are laughing at your failure, then you're not ready to achieve anything in this life. Because they are definitely going to laugh at you whether you like it or not. They will say a whole lot of horrible things to you because you failed. When you fail, you get up. You keep moving. So failure should never be the reason why you quit or you give up on your dreams or you give up on your goals. Number three, don't ever give up on your dreams because you think that you are too old. No, that is the greatest mistake that a lot of people make. No time is too old for success. Success has no age limit. Success has no time limit until you are no more in this life. But as long as you are alive, you can still achieve anything that you set out to achieve, no matter how old you are. You can still go to school and get that degree that you want. You can still start up that business, no matter how old you are. You can still get married. You can still have those children that you've always wanted all your life, no matter how old you are. Whenever you start is your time. Your time starts when you start. It doesn't matter how old you are. So don't ever give up because you think that you're too old to achieve your dreams. You're too old to do this, you're too old to do that. No, there's never a time that is too late to do anything in this life, as long as you're still alive and breathing. So don't give up your dreams because you think you're too old. Number four, you can achieve anything. Yes, and that is true. You can achieve anything you set your mind to. Like Napoleon Hill said, whatever your mind can conceive and believe, you can achieve it. I believe in that quote so much. As long as you can conceive it in your mind, visualize it, it is possible to achieve it. So you can achieve anything in this life. My life is a testimony. I tell people all the time that I am a child of grace, and that is true. My journey is so inspiring, and I'm still on this journey. It hasn't ended for me. Becoming a US citizen today is not my final bus stop. I still have some goals and dreams, other things I want to achieve. So I am still moving forward. God knew that you are capable. That's why He gave you those dreams. That's why He gave you those visions, because He knew that you were capable of achieving them. So don't ever quit on yourself or quit on your goals or your dreams. So whatever it is that you can think from this your mind, believe in it, walk towards it, and believe in yourself. Have that self-confidence in yourself that you can achieve anything in this life. It's not going to be easy, yes, but it is doable. I can testify to that fact, that anything is possible in this life. As long as you believe it. Dreams come true in this life. Keep dreaming. Don't ever stop dreaming. Dream bigger. Dream higher. You can start small. You can start small. But one thing is certain, that if you don't quit, if you don't give up, you will surely and definitely achieve your dreams. The reason I'm here today talking to you guys is because I did not give up on myself or my dreams. If I can be here today, if I can get to this level of my life today, you too can. So don't ever give up on your dreams. Don't ever quit. And for those of you out there who are in the process of becoming a US citizen, I wish you guys all the best. Good luck to you guys. You're gonna do great. Do not be afraid. Do not be scared. Study the civic test, the 2008 civic test. Study your N400 forms, and you're just gonna be fine. If this video encouraged you today, please give it a thumbs up. Hit the subscribe and ring the notification bell. Actually, this is my first video on this channel. So I finally made up my mind to start this channel. I created this channel back in March 2022, and I haven't had the courage to make videos or post anything on this channel. So I finally had the courage to make this video, and I'm going to be making more videos on this channel just to kind of encourage some people out there. I know there are a lot of people out there like me. On this channel, I'll be talking more about insecurities, low self-esteem, self-confidence, love, joy, happiness, success, spirituality, things that have helped me a lot during this process, during this my journey. I'm going to be sharing a lot of those with you guys and encourage you also to help you and know that you can actually achieve your dreams and live your best life. So please support me and subscribe on this channel. Look out for my next video on the things to be grateful for in 2023. Until next time, take care.